This is the NFL on EA Sports as we join you from the so-called Space City, Houston, Texas. Tonight we put a bow on Week 15 with a great Monday night matchup as it'll be the defending Super Bowl champions, the Kansas City Chiefs, taking on the Aviators of Houston. And we are underway from Houston. From a yard or two deep, here comes a return. And he's only going to make it to the 13-yard line and no further. Second down. And Charles, you think about what this defense has had to prepare for. They're in for a battle. I mean, they're facing a team that is working on a 6-game winning streak.
And that can be intimidating when you think about it in those terms, but I think what they need to do is make some sort of a statement early in this game, whether it's a turnover, a takeaway, a key sack on third down, a 3-and-out. Something lets the other guys know that you mean business. Figuratively, throw the first punch and make it a good one.
Second down pass play there, but it's incomplete.
And what we're seeing so far is the defense is certainly coordinated. Both levels doing their jobs in tandem. The back helping the front helping the back. The pressure got home on that last play and forced him to try and throw through contact and short of the sticks.
Third play here this opening drive as they're up against a 3rd and 5. In motion left goes Jones. Mahomes now to throw. Short throw hauled in by Kelce. And they'll bring him down 1 yard shy after a pickup of 4.
Excellent job there defensively. Gave up the underneath to the tight end on 3rd down. And they made sure that they did their job. Got him on the ground and prevented him picking up a 1st down.
So still a scoreless game in the first, but they're going to go for this thing on their own side of the field on 4th down. They'll run for it with Robinson. And he's able to get the first here as he's taken down at the 25. A big roll of the dice on 4th and 1, but it pays off. They convert.
I'm laughing because I'm not so sure I would have made this call. I'm not so sure I would have said, yeah, let's go ahead and get this one, especially at this point of the game. But give him credit. He had a feeling and carried it through.
Yeah, that's one where you think, okay, if you're down 2 minutes left, the ball's near midfield, you go for it. But in this stage, and all the way in for a Kansas City touchdown. Jelani Woods, his 5th touchdown now on the year. And the Chiefs will claim the early lead as they're on the board first here tonight. Extra point by Butker is on target. And that makes the score 7-0. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. On the return, Marcus Jones from the end zone. And in hindsight, probably should have taken a knee as he only gets this out to the 16-yard line. Starts with a carry by Stevenson. And he's taken down, but not before he gets this across the 25. loss of motion before the snap. And this will be our first penalty of the night's proceedings. A full start backs him up five, first and 15. They run once more with Stevenson. And he's able to plow forward up to about the 29, just shy of the 30. They get the penalty yardage back, plus a yard, 6 yard gain, and it's second and 9. This defense for the Chiefs, they were terrific last week in the victory over Buffalo.
And as in any game, takeaways are always a big key. They're always discussed on defense. There's an emphasis there. And they came away with three interceptions in that game.
On play action, they'll throw. And seeing nowhere to throw, he chucks this one away from harm. Incomplete. Now it's third down.
You talk about this Chiefs defense.
They're trying to cover up some holes in the secondary. Right now, bottom five in the league against the pass at number 28.
And I think you're going to see some changes in the offseason, whether it's through the draft, free agency, maybe even both. They definitely need some help in the secondary.
And now the third down throw incomplete as well.
One first down here, and that's all, folks. Good work by this defense to hold things in check and force a punting situation.
Here's Bryce Behringer now. Kadarius Toney deep for KC. Amazing, perfectly placed. If that ball goes one extra yard, maybe not even an extra yard, the starting point is the 20.
So there is a reason that a lot of punters are also excellent golfers. They know distance control. You know what else they have? Same groove motion over and over. Once they have that down, it repeats under pressure.
The KC offense out of the huddle, ready for their next drive. And there, of course, was a lot of talk about this ball game coming into play. Two division leaders in the AFC. Could this be a potential playoff preview down the line?
Yeah, and I think when you talk about the talk about this game coming into play, you're talking about me because I blew up your phone all week prior to this one. I'm so excited about this game because, to me, it's not out of the realm of possibility that these two teams see each other again down the road. I like this matchup. They match up very well against each other.
To avoid punting from their own end zone so they could use something here on third down.
In motion right is Toney.
In his own end zone, it's Mahomes. And a quick throw here, that's complete. And he will have a Chiefs first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
Someone sharp in this game. I mean, a touchdown pass in the first drive and comes right back, and he's flinging it around really well here.
Really nice throw there to pick up the first down. You kind of just feel a laser focus and confidence about him, and I think we saw that this week, didn't we? Talking to him and the coaches, they felt good about his performance coming up.
Yeah, I was really impressed with that last practice we saw when they went through two-minute drill, when they went through all the different situations. Ball hardly hit the ground, and I thought, yeah, he might be locked in for this. Guys picked up all of their assignments, created a nice gap for the running back to get through. Pick up 7 yards. Yeah, he's probably chortling on the headset right now saying, "We got it going, boys. Let's keep it going."
Down the sideline he goes. And out of bounds on the other side of midfield at the 45. 41 yards rushing for him now in his first two carries of the ball game.
As always, no rooting interest here. But that was pretty, wasn't it? To see him break through and then pick up his stride.
Yeah, the guy carrying the ball loves it. I think the O-line, they might like and take more satisfaction out of those runs than anybody else, though, right?
Without a doubt, because they're the ones that often have created it.
Now Mahomes' throw complete to his tight end, Kelce. And he's going to get this inside the 30. They moved the ball over 50 yards between this play and the last one.
Well, as a coach, you absolutely love seeing your offense find their rhythm early, and that's exactly what we've seen so far. They had a touchdown on their opening drive, and now they connect here for another nice gain for a first down. This offense is moving the ball well, exactly as he drew it up in practice.
They go play action. Now Mahomes. And an off-balance throw there, and it's going to wind up incomplete.
One thing that you're going to see from this offense is that they love the matchup with their wide receivers against this secondary. That one wasn't successful, but don't expect them to back away from attacking all game long.
Second and 10. To throw, it's Mahomes. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
Well, it looked like he marched to the end zone. He's hit a momentary roadblock with that incompletion. No need to panic. They just got to come up with a high percentage play call and see if they can get their offense back on track.
This offense was on the move. Now two straight incompletions have them looking at third and 10. Looking to throw is Mahomes. And that is incomplete. Oh, he had a defender right there with him to force that to the ground. And fourth down now coming up. So on fourth down, Mahomes off. Harrison Butker on for the Chiefs field goal. Spotted at the left hash. This from 45. Butker's kick here is good. So another scoring drive there, Charles, and an early two-score lead.
You'd like the six there, partner, but you'll take the three, and I think they have to be happy about the way they moved the ball in these first two drives. They have to feel good about their opportunities the rest of the game.
And this will come out to the 25 as Jones elects for the touchback.
At their own 25-yard line.
Houston's offense already at the line, set to get going. They'll look to get something started. They need to, down 10-0 early, as they've got it first and 10. The throw here caught by Devontae Parker. And he'll be taken down, but not before they reach the 50. It'll go as a gain of 25 on a play that started back at the 25.
You can almost hear the sigh of relief coming from their sideline and from their point on the field, because this has been a tough start for them thus far. A much-needed first down there. They needed something good to happen. Plays like that will continue to help them dig out of this hole.
Cougar 19 tight. Let's go.
From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw. Still going inside the 20. Touchdown! Tyquan Thornton. Are able to strike quickly here as they are in for six. As a former DB, you might not like to see that, but from a wide receiver's perspective, those are the plays they dream of.
Correct on both counts. All right, because once he took off, I mean, let's face it, that should have been done in Big Sky Country. Aren't any speed limits out there? And off he went. Glad I wasn't the one trying to chase him.
Chad Ryland now to add the PAT. And they're back within a field goal. It's 10-7 now. The kicker, Ryland, and he'll send this one away. And able to take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line. The Chiefs offense about set to begin this drive.
And they had a long drive last time, but they had to settle for a field goal, and I'm sure that's how it felt to them, settling. They probably should have gotten in the end zone.
Yeah, not out and out joy, right? Because that's what you get when you put the ball in the end zone. But there are benefits to that type of a long drive. Your defense gets a chance to take a break, adjust a little bit, maybe get themselves ready to get back out on the field and play a little bit better. So they'll take the benefit even though they wanted the 6 points.
Yeah, maybe wore down the other defense. We'll see.
Fire. 10-7 our score after one right here on EA Sports. Inside the 30. 26 big yards on that one. It's another first down.
This is a little bit like baseball here. Strong up the middle. Both sides want to be that. In this case, the offense ends up winning the ultimate battle.
And those big runs between the tackles, that's a little deflating for a defense, isn't it?
It really is, because that's where your strength's supposed to be. You're supposed to be in a spot where they can't make that yardage there. You're supposed to send them outside. Not in this case.
And after the good game last play, this time they say, as he's going to be stopped behind the line of scrimmage. 2 yards the loss, second and 12. Well, sometimes a tough game to figure out. One play he looks so good, and then the next play so bad, going backwards.
Yeah, in a span of two plays, you go from hero to goat, right, to use one of the cliches. But I think what often happens is you have a big run. Try and do too much with your next one.
So the first down run lost a couple. Now they come up second and 12. They'll bring a receiver in motion left. All right, rifles one, and that's going to be intercepted. Picked off by Jalen Mills. And this return is going to be halted right around the 28-yard line. That throw, Charles, over the middle of the field, and a few too many bodies in there got picked.
That's a normal situation too, isn't it? No matter how hard you try and spread the field sometimes, there's always going to be a traffic jam, it feels like, towards the middle. And if there's any type of a missed throw, or maybe the ball's tipped, or just too many bodies in the area, an interception can result.
Panther 11, Panther 11. Viking 18.
Ready. They'll run with Stevenson to begin the drive. He'll be hit down at the 33, 5 yards on the play.
Not a huge play, but I think they're more than happy with how it turned out. Don't be surprised to see them revisit that call, because there was a lane there for more than just 5 yards. Put it in your back pocket and break it out when you need it later.
Come on.
From the 33, here's second down at 5.
Trap 50. Cowboy.
And now an audible here into something else.
19 Lions.
Second and 5. To the right side, he's got Parker. And just 3 yards on the catch there. He couldn't get away. And now 2 yards to go on third down.
Oh, it's time to give a little credit there to the defense. They played that very well, because it was a drag route, and he ran a little shallower than normal as he worked straight across the field. He was hoping he'd get lost behind the defensive line. But once he made the catch, nowhere to turn upfield and gain any yardage.
That is not going to be any help as they dump him behind the line of scrimmage. He loses 4, and it brings up 4.
An interesting and intriguing decision there defensively, because they kept extra DBs on the field despite seeing the multiple tight end look that came out for the offense.
I thought they were going to switch out of it. I didn't know if they felt they didn't have time or what the case was.
Well, in any event, the extra speed allowed for great penetration as they stuffed that one behind the line of scrimmage.
They're going to try and throw. Able to find the open man. That's complete. That'll be touchdown here, but not before he does pick up the first. A gain of 26 and a conversion there as well on fourth down. So now first and 10 in Chiefs territory at the 42-yard line. Stevenson now on first and 10. And a good job of finding the open space to run as he's down close to the 30 here. Back-to-back nice plays, 12 yards that time and a first down. Seemed like a couple sets of eyes were on the quarterback, so he decided, hey, I'm going to hand this off. Got a good gain out of it.
And you know you need good blocking up front in order to gain yardage, but every one of these RPOs, if you do it right and they look the same, whether it's handed off inside or the quarterback keeps it, that allows you to fool the defense so often. And in this case, fooled them with the inside run.
Dragon 60, Buffalo 18, Cup 19, Cup 19.
Back to Stevenson on first down. He'll be dropped at the 25 after a gain of 6.
That's a really nice job by them picking up the run blitz and detecting it and blocking it and turning it into a nice run. And a lot of times you think if you blitz a running play, you're going to smother it. But a lot of the blitzers, they come in a little bit high. They don't have great leverage, and they're easily blocked and turned to the side.
Two minutes remaining in the first half, 10-7, our score. From the 25, here's a second down and 4.
Alert! Alert! Check, Bobcat! Check, Bobcat! Ready?
Again, it's Stevenson. And he's brought down, but not before a gain of 13, down to the 13. First and 10 in the red zone.
I hope we give enough respect to the big guys up front because they have been getting it done on this drive. The holes have been large, and they've been barreling through them, picking up first downs.
Let's go now. Check mash. Check mash. Mustang 19, 79 Broncos. Warriors 70. Go.
On the counter, it's Stevenson. And they corral him just a couple yards shy of the end zone. 61 yards for him on the ground so far tonight as he has been terrific in this first half. The Chiefs now going to use the first of their timeouts. So as they talk it over, we step aside. Stevenson trying to get to the goal line, but he's going to be stopped just short at the 1. No gain on the play, and it's going to be 2nd and goal.
It is definitely hard to find space near the goal line. You always want to have a guy in the game running it who can create his own.
And the Chiefs are going to signal for and be granted another timeout, as they'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the first half.
70 Ranger, 70 Ranger. 7 Pirates, 7 Pirates.
They'll run with Stevenson. And he gets into the end zone. Touchdown, Houston. Ramondre Stevenson, his 7th rushing touchdown of the year. And the Aviators will take the lead here in the final minute of the first half. Extra point by Ryland, up and good. And the lead is now 14-10. Ryland now following the touchdown, back out to kick it away. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30. KC offense out of the huddle, ready for their next drive. With this slim deficit closing in on the end of the first half, we'll see if they can move this at least into field goal range and try to get 3 out of this drive. Call it a gain of 6 on the play, and it'll be second down. And Mahomes going to hustle him up to the line here. Now Mahomes throwing on second down. This ball deep for Tony. And it's knocked away and incomplete. And they're not going to go quietly until they're trying to make every possession count. They took the big shot there, but it winds up incomplete. Yellow. Now they face a 3rd down and 4 after that incompletion on 2nd down. Struggles continue. Here's another one intercepted. Picked up by Jalen Mills. And his guys have got it back at the closing stages of the first half.
But those have been a problem for him all season, but never quite as much as they have in these last few minutes. Let's count it up now. A pair of picks on his team's last 2 drives and double-digit interceptions this season. I don't care if you're the best in the game or an undrafted rookie. You've got to take better care of the football or you're going to cost your team chances.
On for the field goal, a 59-yard attempt.
And this won't get there. Won't be online either. It's no good. Off to the right. That's it for the first half. 2 more quarters to go. We'll have plenty more to see after the break. Welcome back. Halftime over. We are ready for quarter number 3. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number 3. Here's Jones to bring it out of the end zone. And he will make it back to the 15, and that's it. Good coverage there by the kick team.
These guys take over 1st and 10 at their own 15-yard line.
Houston's offense already at the line, set to get going.
Panther 60. Go check.
They'll start this drive out on the ground. And he'll lose yardage here. Back at the 11, he goes down. Chris Jones that time coming in with a tackle behind the line.
And plays like that are exactly what this defense needs here early in the second half to give it a little spark. I think their halftime adjustments, what they talked about, maybe it was just a little inspirational speech. Who knows? But looks like they're ready to go.
Practical 80. 70 Timberwolves. 60 Maverick. 60 Maverick. 18 Rattler. 18 Rattler.
Second and 13. And he slings one that's incomplete.
I think he could have scanned downfield forever, but there wasn't anything available. Ends up throwing an incompletion, and I think he'll take that.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means he'll need to come up with something here on third down. They'll set up a throw. That's caught by his big tight end, Mike Gesicki. And he's got it past the 30 before he's hit and dropped. Able to convert on third and 14, a terrific play call.
Whenever we talk about moving the sticks and controlling the football, there's a great example right there. Those are the third downs you need to convert to win football games. We're in the third quarter of this one, and this is a tight one. In order to maintain pace, keep the ball away from the other team, and put points on the board, those are the plays they need to continue to convert.
Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10.
Panther Street.
Running left is Stevenson. And tough going there as he'll only get it up to about the 31. Brought down by Willie Gay.
Yeah, things were pretty stacked up there in the middle of the line. A lot of bodies, not much space. I think ultimately he was fortunate to get anything out of that run.
Trap 60, trap 60.
Second and 9 now. Flush to his right. And he's just going to get rid of this thing to no one here. He throws it away, and now it's third.
And when you're in a one-score game in the second half, now's not the time to force the football to places where you shouldn't. And that's a smart decision to just get that one out of there.
After an incomplete pass on second down, that'll leave him trying to convert on third and 9. Three. In motion left here, one of their tight ends.
19 Lions. 60 Bobcats. 60 Bobcats. Go.
Here's a play fake as they set up to throw. Now a short one to Gesicki. And he'll be taken down well before the first at about the 36-yard line. So 5 yards here, 5 on the play. And that'll bring up fourth down. They look to throw. He's got his target. That's complete. Down the right sideline. Touchdown. Tyquan Thornton. Two catches, two touchdowns here so far. And the Aviators' decision to go for it pays off with 6 points. That certainly went against the traditional ways of playing football, but who cares? Look at the result. Big touchdown.
They went for it on their own side of the 50. So there's conservative, there's aggressive, and there's really aggressive, which is what we just saw there. Tip of the cap to them.
Extra point by Ryland, up and good. And that makes it a 21-10 game. To the field goal, Riley back out as he'll send this one away. And they're going to mark that where it went out of bounds. So really good starting field position up past the 40-yard line. To lead the Chiefs up first and 10 at the 41-yard line. One back in the backfield, he'll get the carry. And he gets forward up the middle, but only for a couple. It'll be second down. And they're going to hurry back to the line now. They go play fake. Mahomes. He'll get this one to Kelsey. That's complete. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. That goes for a gain of 31.
When they've needed a play this year, he's certainly been the guy to deliver it. As this season has gone on, he's been awfully consistent and sometimes spectacular.
In motion right is Tony. On first and 10, here's Mahomes. No hesitations, they go right back to Kelsey. And in for the Chiefs touchdown. Travis Kelsey, 26 yards. And the Chiefs have got it back to within a score. Now Mahomes to the line as the Chiefs are going to go for the two-point try. Mahomes will throw for it. And he'll get in for the 2 points. So that'll cut the deficit down to just a field goal. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. Oh, the return is Jones from the end zone. And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback. Houston's offense already at the line, set to get going. Their lead down to a field goal now as they start with a first and 10.
Hurt!
They'll start this drive out on the ground. And he's going to take this ahead for right around 3 yards, but no more than that. Second down.
They know that old expression, it's not my night. It hasn't been his so far. I don't know if the legs are a little bit heavy. Sometimes having to hang out all day and play doesn't exactly play to your advantage, but it's been a tough go for him.
And every time he looks up, somebody's there defensively. That was the same case on that play. Off the play fake, he'll look to throw. It's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
Well, that's a good piece of quarterbacking right there because he certainly felt the pressure coming. The alternative, getting sacked for the first time. He didn't like that option at all. Did a nice job saving yardage by throwing that one away.
They head to the line facing a 3rd and 7 following the incompletion on 2nd down. The play action fake. They'll look to throw. Oh, he tries to force it in, and it's intercepted. Mike Edwards picks it up, and he's able to take this one back to the 36-yard line. CD, I know it's just his second year in the league as a quarterback, but that's going to be one when he flips on the tape. He's like, I shouldn't have thrown that ball.
No doubt about it, and his coaching staff will be emphatic about he shouldn't have thrown that ball. But remember, second year, as you noted, on the job training, so he's got to take this feedback that he's getting, negative or otherwise, and turn it into positives moving forward.
As this complete to Woods, he'll be brought down on the 30-yard line after a gain of 6. Looking to speed things up here, going with some tempo. One back in the backfield, he'll get the carry. And tackled down after a gain of 3. Leaves him with 1 yard to go on 3rd down. On play action, it's Mahomes. Steps away, and he can't find anywhere to go with it. And it goes down. It'll be a loss of 8 on the sack, and it's going to lead him to 4th down.
You and I both know we're into a whole new realm of football because we're not just looking at tendencies anymore. We're looking at analytics, and I've got to think the analytics on 3rd and 1 say run the football.
Hey, 43, 43, 15.
Mahomes throwing on 4th. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert, and they turn it over. Andy Reid went for it, but it won't pan out. And as a result, possession switches hands. Houston's offense already at the line, set to get going.
And we'll see if they can bounce back from that last drive. In particular, if they can bounce back at the quarterback position, Charles, after throwing their first interception of the ball game.
Yeah, some guys, you know, they're going to want to try and get a big play right away and take control back. Others, they're going to want to look to hit a couple shorter passes, get a little momentum back that way.
But for the defense, that goal's not changing a bit. They want another pick.
You're exactly right about that. In fact, you've got to watch them a little bit because in coverage, they may cut down their gaps a little bit, maybe their splits a little bit in order to try and get to the ball even faster.
Options galore here. Second and a few inches. Up the middle, here's Stevenson. And he'll be taken down at the 46-yard line. They're going to hurry back to the line now.
Cut that team! Cut that team! Check back! Check back! Left in 19! 46-yard line.
And they're not going to get to the line to run another play. So we will switch ends as the third quarter has come to a close. We'll return with more after this break. You're watching the NFL.
Here we go, here we go. 70 Lions. Check, hurt, hurt.
Ready. A give for Stevenson, running right. Some space here. Touchdown, Houston. Ramondre Stevenson with his second touch. Played a pivotal role with those two TDs and why they're up on the scoreboard right now.
Well, someone's all about winning, aren't they? Because he's not worried about the number. Sure, it's great to have two touchdowns. But the bottom line is what he's doing is contributing to their lead. He wants to continue to do so.
Extra point by Ryland, up and good. And his guys will take a 10-point lead. Back out is the kicker, Ryland, and he'll send this one away. They'll elect to bring it out here from the end zone. And in hindsight, probably should have taken a knee as he only gets this out to the 16-yard line. The Chiefs offense about set to begin this drive. And you figure after giving up that last touchdown, you know, they trail by two scores here in the fourth quarter. This drive becomes very critical. And quickly, they get to the line. On second down, here's Mahomes. And Mahomes misfires again, and it's intercepted. Picked up by the Michigan man, Jabril Peppers. Well, that's three picks he's now thrown in this game.
And I know this, the holiday season, because here we are in December. Right, it is the season of giving. Maybe for his own sake, after the game, he may have to announce that he's donating certain amounts to charity for each interception that he threw.
Okay, ready? Red Lion, go!
They'll try the left side with Stevenson. And not a whole lot of room to operate there on the first down run. He gets maybe three.
Well, that's a pretty good drive starter right there. And I don't know, partner, if you're even thinking about sitting on the ball right now. They may just want to run their regular offense.
In plus territory. And as an offensive coordinator, you don't want your team to go into a shell, do you?
No, you really don't. Because as soon as you take your foot off the gas, it's real hard to put it back on and mash it. Because once everyone's emotions come down, hard to start him up again, so I think he may want to keep him cranking high right here.
Okay, great.
Second and seven.
Go, Rig, go. Ready.
To the right side, this is Stevenson. And he's out of bounds, almost gets to the 10. 146 yards on the ground for him now as he's gotten better, really, as the night's gone on. And carries like that, that's how they're going to continue to salt this thing away here, Charles, in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, how about that? A new set of downs. Clock continues to move. No better way to close out a game than to tap those mastodons you have up front and say, guys, keep pounding them. Let's keep the ball, keep their offense on the sidelines, and let's close this one out.
On the ready.
Now a first and 10 at the 11.
60 Eagles, 60. 18 Cardinal, 18 Cardinal. Hey, hey, check that, check that. Hey, smash Broncos. 79 Broncos. Warriors, 70.
Up the middle, here's Hallion. And he will maneuver his way down to about the 7. A gain of 3, second down.
Well, that's not a run that's going to make any of the highlight tapes, but they've been moving it well all game on the ground. This is another one that keeps them moving forward.
They'll come up second and 7.
Hey, check that, streak, streak.
Again, it's Elliott. And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. No gain on the play, and it's going to bring up a third down.
All runners count on their eyes to find the gaps and creases, to find open space. There was absolutely none on that one. Totally swallowed up on that play.
The offense on third down tonight, just 1 for 5 to this point. This is 3rd and 7. Straight ahead, it's Stevenson. And he's in. Touchdown, Houston. Ramondre Stevenson. His 3rd touchdown of the game, 10th on the year. And the Aviators add on to their lead, and they are also closing in on a 5th straight victory.
We see this a lot on 3rd and short yardage, especially down here in the red zone. They're going to sell out to stop the run, try and hold them to a field goal. But once the running back gets past the first wave, the resistance can evaporate after that. And he not only picks up the first, but he takes it all the way into the end zone.
Extra point by Ryland, up and good. And that'll make this a 3-score game now. The lead moves to 17. Ryland now following the touchdown, back out to kick it away. And this will come out to the 25 as Hamler elects not to return it. KC offense out of the huddle, ready for their next drive. This has been frustrating for them to this point. They have not looked the same as they did coming in, riding that impressive 6-game win streak. And the offense moving quickly to the line.
It's a gain of 5. Brings up second.
Mahomes to throw on 2nd down. He's going to loft one deep left side here. And that will be incomplete. Tried to dial up the long one way out there, but it'll be 3rd down.
And they're at the point of the ball game now where they've got to take some chances. They've got to put the ball in the air and just see what happens. But this defense knows that all too well.
They come up now 3rd and 5 following the incomplete pass. Working from the gun, Mahomes. That is caught. And he will have a Chiefs first down as they're able to get the 3rd down conversion.
A gain of 9 yards. First down, Chiefs.
Yellow.
On 1st down, Mahomes. And for the 4th time tonight, it's an interception. Picked up by the Michigan man, Jabril Peppers. Well, just another reason to celebrate there on the defensive side with the interception, and this is a game that they clearly have firmly in their grasp.
Yeah, a lot of handshakes, a lot of hugs, a lot of smiles. It's been their day.
Houston's offense already at the line, set to get going. And after the interception, they are sitting in an even better spot with the ball and a comfortable 4th quarter lead. They'll start on the ground here on first down. And slow going there as he'll only get a yard, maybe, up to the 41. The fourth quarter here, they've got the lead. They want to keep it on the ground. That's what they're doing.
Smart football. Keep the clock grinding. Keep it going. But you got to figure now, they're going to see more people stacked up at the line of scrimmage as they try and bleed it out.
Ready, set.
Now we're at the 41, second and nine.
Go. Check, smash. Check, smash. Go, check. Go, check. 70 Ranger. 70 Ranger.
They stay on the ground, but this time it's Elliott. And he'll be tackled right on the midfield logo.
That's it. That's what you want. Straight ahead, positive gain. Just keep that clock ticking.
They don't need to run another play here before the two-minute warning. Let's see if they do it anyway. Two minutes left to play in this football game here on EA Sports. So it's our home team here in possession of the football as we come back. They've got a third down now as they look for one more first down to help salt this one away.
60 Maverick, 60 Maverick.
Ready? On play action, they'll throw. Open man, Smith-Schuster, it's complete. And he's corralled, but not before getting it inside the 35. Catch number 44 of on the year. It's a first down. Well, clear running situation. Trying to take time off the clock. You ran the previous play. Set that play action up nicely.
Boy, did they ever, because they had shown the ability to run the football. So now you lose your keys as a defense. You dive for the running play, and they hit them over the top.
Now it looks like he'll throw here. He'll get this out wide here to Elliott. And that's good for a gain of six, and it'll be second down.
Just about every quarterback is trained to really look downfield first before you come back and make a nice, safe throw. And in this case, that's exactly what he did. Found his running back, let him create some space, and it turned out to be a nice play for the offense.
Now, meanwhile, here's a second down throw that's knocked away and incomplete. With that matchup, the adjustment that was made, you have a blazing guy on a blazing guy, and defensively, he won that battle.
The closing speed is the key. When you have a guy that fast and he can close at the end of a play and knock it away, that's a big deal, and we just saw him do it right there.
18, fight in.
Back to throw again. Able to find the open man. That's complete. And he'll be taken down, but he does have first down yardage. A strong 8 yards will keep this drive rolling.
They've been moving the ball well, but this drive is in danger of stalling out. Fortunately, this is a nice throw here, and they're able to pick up a new set of downs.
Now a play fake here on first down. And got his man. It's caught. Touchdown, Houston. Tyquan Thornton from 21 yards away. And the Aviators extend this fourth quarter lead, and they are getting closer and closer to win number 11. A nice throw there by the second-year quarterback.
And I don't believe that was the kind of play he would have made as a rookie, because usually your rookie season is a continuation of your college days. A lot of one read, and if you don't have it, you just take off and go. Now he's settled in the pocket a little bit more, reading the field and getting to a second and sometimes third progression. That was a nice play.
So after the field goal, Ryland back out as he'll send this one away. And by rule, that comes out to the 40-yard line, so good opportunity for this offense with solid field position.
Yellow.
So good starting field position for him here as they come up first and 10 at the 41-yard line. One back in the backfield, he'll get the carry. Well, he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. That burst good for 20 and a first down.
We'll definitely see some open running lanes, and he's taking advantage of it right now, but that shouldn't be a surprise. Defense has the lead. They're playing for the pass first.
So here's a first and 10 at the 38. Running game working. They'll stick with it on first down. And he'll work it inside the 30 to the 29-yard line. Now whistles and a timeout called here. Not sure of the point of this, but they'll stop it with 4 seconds to go in the game. One final try for Mahomes. And that is incomplete. 2 seconds left on the clock.
Well, we've talked about it, CD, but it bears repeating. They are struggling to throw the football. All the interceptions and more incompletion.
Route.
Drill, bucket of ice on me, how should I chill? Scoping your mop, watch how I know how I'm rocking, you know how I'm built. Still in the trenches, we out in the field. If she in her bag, then it's Prada Chanel. The is fake, but she popping for real. Still that way, run up if you feel that way. You can get this work, but the work don't ship, cause it really don't feel that way. Seen a whole lot of rapping and a whole lot of get like ice. Yesterday's price is not today's price, talk to me nice. You know I'm an Eastside, big TD, East of a whole rep. Top dog since top ramen now, stack a lobster with a shrimp fat. Big, put a ribbon on it, get you gift wrap. Bet that, real never switch that. Came a long way, came a long way, came a long way, came a long way. Been a long way, real been a long way. And it's still that way, still that way, still that way. Still broad day, live that way, drill that way. Came a long way.
What you mean you don't know how I'm stepping? What you mean you don't know what I'm repping? I'm feeling my hood like they call me the best. When you jacking my side, you gotta come and check in. After we get hectic, dumb and me slide up on you, no electric. You hear
hit them like it's Tetris. You felt the way and all you do is text and listen. I don't know why they mentioning beef. I don't think no one better than me. You can say what you want, but my step was on speak. If I tell them to go, then they stepping on three. Like, bought a chain that's competitive. Me making rain in your hood like I weather the streets. My label, we good. I'ma get to the breach. You only as tough as your weapon could be. I done caught me a dealing. I got off the block. To the hate and put that in the watch. Had the ice on my neck cause I'm surely on hot. If some rappers that want me to flop, I don't care about no dissing cause none of them pop. And I'm shooting my stars off a pop. They be all on my DM. Like, when you gon' drop? Look, it get boring, just me at the top. It get boring, just me at the top. I be shaking their hearts every time that I drop. Like, when I walk in the spot, it says, you won't be in this if you don't make it hot. Like, huh, new deal. AP, I done signed up with Def Jam. Jay-Z, got the in my left hand. Play me every time that I step them. Hate me like what? Play with the gang and you play with your life. Put a bag in your head, it don't matter the price. Put on their neck, so I got me some ice. If I'm dissing you once, I ain't saying it twice. Said, I got time today. I done stepped in the field. I got time to play. And my exes are the bear, time to wait. Black and I said, I need time away. Like, what you mean you don't know how I'm stepping? What you mean you don't know what I'm repping? I'm good on my hood like they call me the blessing. You jacking my side, you gotta come and check in. That's the way it get hectic. Don't make me slide up on you, no electric. Black and hit them like it's Tetris. You felt the way and all you do is text and listen.
Sometimes they call me Lucifer. Talk about you do this and that. Ain't none of that. They're new to us. Acting like that you popped off. No damn well that you grew